Drama unfolds late night on a Sunday evening outside the speaker's residence. Shehzad Poonawalla of the BJP with us. Thank you so much, Shehzad, for speaking with us here on CNN News 18. Is this a pressure-building tactic by Gehlot? Is this him nudging the top brass here in Delhi that it's my way or the highway, you have no other option?
No, that is really for the Congress party to decipher what its internal dynamics are. Obviously, Mr. Ashok Gehlot is clearly sending out a loud and clear message to the Gandhis, whose credibility and whose popularity within the party too seems to be completely eroded. But having said that, today I am feeling perturbed about the people of Rajasthan. It is the people of Rajasthan who have to face this and see this. When this government came to power, even then you saw the kind of power politics that played out. 50 days the MLAs were in hostels and hotels and they were trying to just grab power. Rajasthan suffered, and tonight again Rajasthan suffers. Instead of having cabinet meetings to decide as to how Rajasthan can be made rape mukt, danga mukt, aparad mukt, you have people playing petty political power games at the behest of the Congress first family, and Rajasthan is suffering, and therefore today's images are only a reinforcement of what is going to happen in 2023. People are going to reject this government, they're going to throw them out, and they're going to replace them with a strong and stable government, a double engine ki sarkar very soon.
This is the BJP, of course, eyeing an entry in ahead of elections next year, Shehzad, but the MLA is there going on to say that we don't really want to resign. The government is not going to fall. This is just to show that there are 92 on our side. And this is perhaps Gehlot trying to say that, the support is with me. So this whole one man, one position, one post principle of the Congress party cannot stand with me, because if I go, or if you replace me as the Chief Minister of Rajasthan, then you're going to lose the government.
Well, that is for the Congress party to tell us now that when Mr. Gehlot is clearly giving a strong and a stern message to the Gandhis that he will listen to nobody and he will do what he wants to do on his own, then it is for the Gandhis to now and for the Congress party to tell us what happened to their Udaipur declaration. And frankly, this was always marked and lined with hypocrisy. We know that Indira Gandhi was the president and the prime minister. We know Rajiv Gandhi was the president and the prime minister. So the Gandhis have always held two positions for one person, and they were lecturing Ashok Gehlot, and clearly Ashok Gehlot doesn't want to take it lying down.
Right, Shehzad Poonawalla, thank you so much for speaking with us here on CNN News 18. The BJP there claiming this is nothing but a sham, but CNN News 18 getting you the very latest of the drama there.